I know it's early on a Saturday morning, but let's not forget today is cut day. I want to keep you up to date. Welcome to Believers Talk. Welcome to this early morning edition where it's cut down day. That's right, by 4 p.m. today, the Buffalo Bills have to have their 91-man roster cut down to 53 guys. Now, we know they've already made some cuts yesterday. We know about the trade with Bodine going over to the Patriots for a sixth-round pick. That means we have three sixth-round picks in 2020. We're not going to use all those picks, so it's kind of exciting to think about what we're going to do with all the extra draft capital. We picked up the extra fifth round pick. Now we have picked up two extra sixth round picks. So it's a good thing so far in Buffalo. Again, early morning here on a Saturday, but we wanted to keep you up to date on everything going on. I'm going to be on the road a lot today. So make sure you hit that subscribe button, guys. Would love to go live with you on my cell phone. Need to get over 1,000 subscribers in order to do that. But I will be trying to keep you guys updated when the cuts come in. So what is going on right now? I'll go through some of the cuts from already today. The Buffalo Bills have released Marcus Murphy, running back. Again, not surprised. We know that running back room's full, right? So we knew that there'd be some tough cuts. Marcus Murphy, big return, week four preseason. I really liked him last year. Was hoping for big things last year. Didn't provide those things. Was kind of let down. So to see him be released this year, not a surprise by me. We released Captain Munderland. This might be a surprise to some people. Captain Munderland, we signed him when we got rid of EJ Gaines due to the injury settlement. So we thought that that Captain Munderland might stay on this team. His ties with Sean McDermott, his ties with Carolina Panthers, Coach McDermott, Brandon Bean, things like that. We thought he had a shot to make this team. We released him today per Ian Rappaport. So No huge surprise, I wouldn't say. I mean, we know our secondary has pretty good depth, but just, again, with his ties with Coach McDermott within Carolina, thought maybe he had a chance to stay. We release Ray McLeod. Now, this will start giving us some insight maybe on who that sixth wide receiver is, right? A lot of people thought we'd keep McKenzie over McLeod, so releasing McLeod might be a good sign for Isaiah McKenzie to make this team. Also release Kyle Pecco. Excuse me, guys, still not feeling the best, but the Bills released Kyle Pecco, defensive tackle. No surprise there. Sam Acho has been released. We talked before the last preseason game about with Love going on IR that the last spot was between Eddie Yarborough and Sam Acho for the defensive end spot. So maybe this is good for Eddie Yarborough. Maybe that means he has made the team. Or maybe, like I thought for a long time, we're going to look at some other waived players at that defensive end position and see if we can even get better at that defensive end spot. So look for maybe Eddie Yarborough to have clinched that spot there. Give me 1 second. I'm going to continue to go through these. Waived Tyree Jackson. No surprise there. Again, we're only going to keep those two quarterbacks. So we have waived rookie QB Tyree Jackson. Might see us try to put him on that practice squad. Release safety Abraham Wallace. Defensive tackle Roderick Young. Wide receiver Victor Bolden, which I think some of these are going into yesterday evening. We released defensive tackle LT Walton. Released Matthew Fairburn. And then it talks about the trade with the New England Patriots. So I'm on Buffalo Rumblings, getting my tracker going, constantly trying to keep you guys up to date on what's going on. So like I said, I'll be traveling today. We'll try to give you guys updates on my cell phone and post them on here as well. But I want to keep you guys as up to date as possible. So guys, remember, hit that subscribe button. Love to get over 1,000 subs. So like I said, I can go live with you guys just on my cell phone whenever breaking news happens. But I am going to keep you up to date on all Buffalo Bills news. So hit that subscribe button, like this video, and leave a comment what you think of the releases so far. Again, the big name's probably Captain Munderland. A little bit of a surprise there. Ray McLeod, we got him last year in the draft. He did all right at times, but again, maybe practice squad eligible, so we're going to keep on the practice squad. Who knows? But good signs made for Isaiah McKenzie. Good signs for Eddie Yarborough, if you're an Eddie Yarborough fan. Had a big game week four preseason, and we knew that it was probably going to be between him and Sam Acho as far as who makes the team. And right now, with Sam Acho being released, Eddie Yarborough has made his case to make this 53-man roster. Guys, it's going to be like this all day, so you want to stay right here at Believers Talk. Again, not sure how fast I get these out to you, but I will do my best. Make sure you guys have the most up-to-date Buffalo Bills coverage. And again, these ones won't be that long. They'll be pretty quick because I want to get you guys that coverage. So again, comment. Let me know what you think about the releases so far. Like this video. Helps out the channel. And again, subscribe before the season begins. Lots of fun things coming 2019. I look forward to talking to y'all soon. Until I do, go Bills.